hit me.
Ladies and gentlemen, get into it.
Get on up.
The choice is yours.
You can get with this.
Or you can get with that. You can get with this, or you can get with that. You can get with this, or you can get with that.
There's a lot of confusion among people and misinformation surrounding face masks. Can you discuss that?
The masks are important for someone who's infected to prevent them from infecting someone else. Now, when you see people and look at the films in China and South Korea, whatever, everybody's wearing a mask. Right now in the United States, people should not be walking around with masks.
You're sure of it? Because people are listening really closely to this.
Right now, people should not be walking. There's no reason to be walking around with a mask. When you're in the middle of an outbreak, wearing a mask might make people feel a little bit better, and it might even block a droplet, but it's not providing the perfect protection that people think that it is.
What's up with that? What's up with that?
And often, there are unintended consequences. People keep fiddling with the mask and they keep touching their face.
And can you get some schmutz sort of staying inside there?
Of course.
Well, it's just one contradiction after another. He says that masks may not necessarily work, but how about social distancing? Does that work?
Phil? Hey, Phil Connors!
Ned?
So much for social distancing. The lockdowns continue, although it's come to a point where we really don't understand why. Because all the data that these professionals have provided has been wrong in many, many, many ways. I don't recall this happening, once again, I repeat myself, with the H1N1 situation. Whereas there are so many inconsistencies from then to now. You know, they discovered 10 years later that it was a whole lot deadlier than what it really was. And of course, if you look it up, when the first cases originated, which was in about March or April of 2009, there was a public health emergency that was put in place. However, it wasn't until many months later that the Obama administration decided to declare it a national emergency. Now, you may hear it from MSM that that wasn't so, that they try to say that, no, he did a good job with it and all kinds of great stuff that they say. However, it's not true. And here, right here, you can see that in October of 2009, finally, he declared a national emergency, whereas the first cases were in April. So if there was a public health emergency in April, why did he wait so long? However, they want to take what this president has done and really want to exploit it as to him not doing such a good job. I don't believe so. There are many people that support the fact that he has done a good job, and there are many people that are really very tired of being locked in and locked down.
This isn't about the virus, people. This stopped being about the virus a long time ago. Do you remember being told that we were going to go back to work in March?
Yep. Yeah. Yeah.
Do you remember being told we were going to go back to work the middle of March?
Yep.
Do you remember being told we were going to go back to work in April?
Yep.
Do you remember being told that we were going to go back to work after they flattened the curve?
Yep. That's right.
Is the curve flattened?
Yeah.
So why aren't we back to work?
I mean, it has been discovered that here in Pennsylvania, that 70% of the deaths were in nursing homes. New York City has finally admitted, about a week or so ago, that 66% of their deaths were, of course, in nursing homes or people that were locked in their homes. They don't want you to go outside, but they want you to die inside.
Going to tear down your safe space. Brick by brick, I shall smash it with glee.
What? Who is that?
You cannot stop me from getting inside. I am cold and I am hard, and my name is reality.
But what I know to be true is that this virus isn't going away. And that additional people are going to get sick, and additional people are going to die. It's not a good thought, but it's reality. Our governor and our mayor refuse to acknowledge the reality of this situation. The reality is not so much that these people are going to get sick and some people are going to die. The reality is that we're the walking dead. We're not allowed to feed our families. They're looking at making us lose our businesses. Why?
The powers that be cannot really provide us an answer. It's almost as if they're drunk with control, that they cannot see clearly enough to understand what it is that is the real plight. People are losing their businesses, their homes. Families may be falling apart. That's an even sadder situation than the virus itself. They're not even clear. As I've always said before and in previous videos, there has always been a situation every year where thousands of people die. However, those issues or those situations are not ever exploited as this one has been. Yeah, do I believe that this has been politicized? Most certainly do. And it's unfortunate that because of certain people, we all pay the price. This is not just a partisan virus. Everyone is suffering from it, as they suffer every year. But I need to repeat myself. It's not ever done this way. It's not. Who in their lifetime has ever experienced a lockdown? And given the lame excuses as to the reasons why, like we as people are not capable. We do not need these elected officials to tell us exactly how to live. That's what they want to do. They want to tell us how to live. They want to put in certain legislations where they would do contact trace or whatever. Even as far as I believe is trying to put a chip in someone, which I will discuss in another video, to see where you are, where you've been, and what you're doing. It's getting bad, folks. And the solution that these people are offering is making it worse. Let the people go back. You know, that's the way it is, you know. What was it that I read? That the cure can be worse than the virus itself?
First of all, when they talk about the virus, there are many viruses that are part of this pandemic. In fact, early on, we knew there were 8 different substrains. Now there are as many as 30. So the idea of making a single vaccine to chase 30 different substrains of viruses, it's that vaccine is going to be all benefit, all risk and no benefit, because by the time it comes to market, that vaccine or the virus would have continued to morph and change, and it will not address the current virus that's in circulation. The second thing I think you need to know is this new vaccine that's going to be coming to market is completely experimental. They have never done a vaccine like this, injecting raw viral RNA into human beings ever before. And when they have done animal studies in the past, they did not go well, and the animals ended up with accelerated autoimmune disease, and many of them died. To fast track this virus, to generalize the population with not studying it long term and not going through any of the appropriate channels to bring a vaccine to market, which usually at the shortest term is 5 years, puts your population in your country at risk.
Come on. You know, people want to be free. People want to be able to do their own thing. And it's happening. People are yelling out loudly from Pennsylvania, where I'm at, to New York City, where I have family. Everywhere. People are stepping up. Look at what's going on in Michigan. You know, that governor wants to keep everybody locked down and telling you what's essential. However, she feels that abortions are essential. Isn't that weird? You know, so you're trying to save lives, but still take lives. It makes no sense whatsoever. Now, of course, I'm not denying that there isn't anything going on. However, what if we looked at it in a different way? Because all we hear on the news is about deaths. This many deaths, it is. But how about if we look at it this way? I found this meme on Twitter, and I thought it was very, very interesting. It was a refreshing look at things. I forget exactly who it is that put it out. But look at it. You know, 99.983% here in the U.S. on survival rates. And all across the board there, look at that, 99.99.99. That's a good way of looking at it. Not this peer porn that's going on right now to keep people afraid and keep people away from each other. That's not the way to go. You know, this has divided the country in a way that is unprecedented, and it's a shame that it is that way. I want to thank my man Rob up there in New York City, who's always looking at my videos. I appreciate it, you know. I haven't worn a tie yet, but I will. I want to thank Tom and Carol also for always providing good content. Carol provided the video from Staten Island. Greatly appreciate it. I want to thank Arnie Beiser, who always puts out good content, and I want to snatch it all. And, of course, Deplorable TD. I tell you, with these folks and the stuff that they provide, these videos would be a couple of hours long, so I'm not always able to put everything in there. It's been a very busy weekend, and hoping to get life started. Looking forward to the next 5 minutes, not just tomorrow. I want to thank everyone. I want to thank everyone on Twitter. Please hit the subscribe button, or you can follow me on Twitter at MonsterJammaKSG. And I want to send out blessings to everyone, as everyone also blesses me. Baruch Hashem and Amen. Get on up.